Hoopers and a random here for another one trick a day. Today we're going to be going over the vortex. The reason why I've chosen this trick is because we did the corkscrew not too long ago, and I feel like once you've learned the corkscrew, the next step is to go into the vortex, because it's pretty much the corkscrew, just instead of just going up, you're also going to be coming back down. Start on your hips. Just like we did with the corkscrew, I'm going to stay in a rotating position because it's easier. Four fingers in the back. Keep it towards the center or more to the left if you're using your right arm. Straight up and back down. Straight up and back down. Once you've been hooping longer, you'll be able to hold this and look a lot more graceful. I, of course, am still learning it. Once again, I'm a beginner hooper just like you. Up and back down. That was really sloppy. Once again, beginner hooper. Up and back down. And that's the vortex. Just realized I was doing that with one hand. That's so exciting because the one hand is harder than the two hand. My bun kind of got in the way of that one. Isn't it exciting when you figure out a trick? It's so exciting. Earlier today, we did the can-can trick, which since it is kind of getting dark out, I'd like to show you that again. So once again, with the can-can kick, all you're doing is moving your hands like this, literally just letting the hoop guide over your hands. It's the most basic of basic tricks. And then you're just kicking your leg and bringing the hoop around it. Kick. Kick, 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 stop, kick. And I'm Anna Random, and those are my one tricks a day. Thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it.